List of those countries which imposes higher level of restrictions even in the trade of services. So which, where are we like lacking?
Well, I would want you to, I'd like to give my interpretation of what I've said. It was one of the charts which was seen, it was one of the bar charts which was shown. And to show that India has maximum levels of protection, whether it is in financial services or any other, is interesting from the point of view of facts. But what is the reality behind it? Why should India be asked to questions about market access law, particularly in services, when there is not enough transparency? I also spoke about how agreements, even agreed agreements, meaning which are in place, don't give us all that is agreed. So, to put that bar chart without speaking about the reality with which India is sitting, for me, made it necessary to make a reference to it.
Well, GST is being rolled out on July 1st. There's a lot of worry from the exporter side that the GST coming in, exports would come in the beginning. So, how is Commerce Ministry looking at how prepared are we for GST being rolled out?
I'm not sure I agree with that information. GST, on the contrary, gives a feeling that and a rightful that market in India is one now. There are no barriers between regions or provinces. Even within the country, the value chains which will get integrated will have a simpler flow, straightforward flow, and therefore it should make exports more competitive rather than expensive.
And what does the government intend to do on H-1B visas?
Well, I think there's a lot to be said both in Parliament and otherwise. The Secretary of Commerce together with the Foreign Secretary did go, and the impression that we've had is that their focus today of the new administration in the US is on the larger issue of immigration, and the notification which they have given for H-1B visa for the year 2018 says there's no change in position, which means they normally do it 1 year in advance. We find that there's no change.